This is the structure of singleton pattern. We'll see how this is implemented in PHP source. Here is the class singleton. It has a static data item instance initialized with null value. And here is the another data item data. Here is the constructor of singleton class. It is private so that singleton class object cannot be created directly. Here is the method instance. Inside this, we are checking the value of instance. If it is null, then we are creating the object of singleton class and we are assigning it to the data item instance. And here we are returning the instance, which is pointing to the singleton class object. Here is the method setData. It has parameter as a variable value, and inside this we are assigning this value to the data item data. Here is the method getData. Inside this we are returning the data item data value. Okay, we'll see how all this is used. So here we are assigning the value 10 to the variable value, and here we are calling the method instance of singleton class. So it comes here, and initially the value of data item instance is null. So it creates the singleton class object and assigns it to data item instance, and then it returns the data item instance, which is pointing to the singleton class object. Now we are calling the setData method, where value is passed as parameter. So it comes here, and this value is assigned to the data item data. So the value is 10. So the data item data value will be 10. Here we are calling the instance method of singleton class. So again it comes here, but this time instance is not null and singleton class object is already existing. So it returns the existing singleton class object, which is pointed by instance. So it comes here, and here it calls the method getData. So it will come here and it will return the data item data, which has value 10. So here it will display data equal 10. We'll run this program and we'll see the output. Okay, we can see the data equal 10. So with this method, we are setting the data item data with value 10. And with this method, we are getting the data item data value, which is 10. And when we call this method, it creates the singleton class object. And when we call again this method, then it returns the existing singleton class object, which is pointed by instance.